To begin with the highlights for today, the president of Tanzania, John Magufuli, says he will not lock down Tanzania. He is sending a plane to Madagascar to fetch a herbal tonic touted as a cure for COVID-19, even as the WHO warned there was no proof of any cure. The US officials believe that China intentionally concealed the severity of the pandemic to stock up on medical supplies needed to respond to it. A Florida medical examiner sent emails begging officials to close local beaches. The beaches will open with almost no restrictions tomorrow. In Afghanistan, Afghan officials were hunting on Sunday for Afghan migrants in a river bordering Iran after reports that Iranian border guard tortured dozens and threw them into the water to feed them out of Iran. Russia is rapidly becoming one of the world's coronavirus hotspots and has just reported a record 10,000 cases in a day. India's military salutes virus workers with rose petals fly past. Helicopters showered masked health workers with rose petals and jets roared across the skies on Sunday as India's military paid tribute to frontline workers battling the coronavirus pandemic. In Washington, Oxford scientists say its vaccine is making headway, could show efficacy by June. Dozens of Rohingya refugees stranded at the sea for weeks have been relocated to controversial flood-prone island in the Bay of Bengal, Bangladesh officials said on Sunday. Gilead is yet to set a price for the corona treatment Remdesivir, but an influential drug pricing watchdog says it could be worth up to $4,500 per patient. Random coronavirus testing indicates nearly a third of Kabul could be infected. China has condemned a U.S. tweet backing Taiwan's push for participation at the United Nations as a global body works with its 193 member states to tackle the coronavirus pandemic. And the rise in corona cases in crowded Indian jail prompts concern. This is Jyoti reporting for Our Voice.